Hi everybody, and welcome to the latest instalments of the Salmon Wrap Care. Today's session is going to be all about feeding the older and infirm rats. So this is particularly aimed at kind of older rats that are struggling to keep their weight on, perhaps that might have some other conditions going on. I'm joined particularly by my two older rats, which are Luna and Monster. Luna's currently wildly on heat, which is quite amusing, so she may not stay here very long. She might be off very, very soon, but Monster's a sweetheart, so hopefully she'll stick around. So, when do you have to start thinking about feeding older rats differently? So there are two kind of main triggers for this. As rats get older, certain parts of their organs will start to kind of degrade. It's natural, it's part of aging, and it's particularly common of one organ in particular, which you've probably heard me mention before, which is kidneys. So kidneys are one of the rat's weak links. They basically filter out a lot of stuff, and as the rat gets older and older, these filters get kind of clogged up effectively, so work less and less effectively. The thing with kidneys is we only really see and know that there's a problem in most cases when the kind of kidney function is significantly decreased. So at that point you'll have had lots of different little kind of stuff going on, it'd be gradually getting worse, and you'll be able to have less of an effect by diet. So it's why we, like when I was talking about my kind of simple diet and my full mix that I make, you'll notice that I do talk about kidneys an awful lot, because it's a good kind of practice to, sorry, Luna's been very amusing every time I stroke a button.
You're gonna show it off.
You're gonna show off your fluttering for the camera. If we never see this again, the rat is on heat, that's why she's so jumpy when it's my touchy butt. Anyway, yeah, so that's why I feed a general kidney-friendly diet, because you don't know when the kidney problems are going to start. However, it's worth kind of bearing in mind that once a rat's about 18 months old plus, the likelihood is they've got a kind of proportion of damage to their kidneys. Now, Monster's a particular case, because Monster definitely has damage to her kidneys, and she's had it quite young. I'm not sure exactly what happened. I suspect there was some sort of infection that caused kind of minor damage to her kidneys, but she's had kind of off symptoms for a while, and she's had various blood tests and has come back with her having kidney problems. So she's actually been on a kidney-friendly diet particularly kidney-friendly diet for quite a while. So there are different levels of kidney-friendly diets, and it's very critical for oldies that you take this into account. Like I say, my dry mix is generally fairly friendly. That means it's a low phosphorus diet with no more protein than they need, and that's kind of key to giving them this general decent level of kind of kidney friendliness. As the rats get older, so with Monster and Luna, they now regularly get extras as well, which help, because one of the classic signs of kidney problems is the rat starts to lose weight gradually. And Monster's a very good example of this, so let's see if she'll put her foot on my hand properly so we can get a pose going. But you see that she's quite pinched in here. I can probably show you better with her out long. Ignore her slightly shaved belly, that was from her blood tests. She's not a big rat. She feels in the hand quite bony. She's got a fairly prominent spine. It's not showing up great on video, it's more of a touch thing. She is underweight. I know she's underweight. If you ever want to see up to there, perhaps let's try and just give you a quick tweak, which is another trick which can actually help with older rats. You'll see all my weights for all my rats. I measure these monthly. I'll explain why for older rats. Sorry, this was a narrow Luna pancake, but Luna survived. And Moggle Mug's now joined us as well. Oh, and Chocobo, we've got the whole gang. Nearly. Right, so so once they start showing these kind of symptoms, this is the same for kind of most old rats. You might also see a bit of hind leg degeneration creeping in, that's often kidney related. Generally speaking, it's especially true, you see it a lot in kind of my family. They'll keep the weight great to a certain age, then one day they'll just start like struggling to keep weight a bit. And that might be the kidney, that might not. Some of the times it is, some of the times it's just kind of old age. They become less efficient at processing all their kind of nutrients. And that's when you need to start thinking a bit cleverer about how you feed them and feeding them a bit extra. But obviously my old girls live in a group with lots of youngsters as well, such as little jocks. So I have to respect that and make sure that my young girls aren't going to get fat being fed enough to keep the oldies. So how do you manage in a mixed group? And actually, how do you manage even if they're taken out of a mixed group? So I will keep mine together as long as possible. If it comes to the point where I genuinely can't keep the weight on the rat whilst they're in that mixed group, I'll consider separating them. But thankfully, I rarely have to do that. So there is a few options. One of the first things I do when I notice older rats kind of struggling to keep that weight on, I'll start to take them out. For at first, it might be a couple of hours. And in the key with this is aim for the time of day that is between feedings by a decent amount. So you don't want to feed them just before they're going to get fed anyway, because then they'll fill the bellies up and then they're not going to get the fair share of the normal food. So you have to kind of bear that one in mind. Another thing that can help is split, if you're feeding only once a day, split your daily feeds into twice daily, and that'll give them two kind of goes at it, because often they're just a little bit slower at eating than the youngsters. So they get two goes at the feed, and mine often also, like, they'll eat enough to fill themselves up and then they'll stop, because sometimes you want them to just eat and eat, and not all rats do that. Quite nice that they don't when you're trying to keep weight off them, but it's very difficult when you're trying to put weight on them. So you have to then make sure that they're either getting extra food when they're hungry, or that the food they're eating is more nutritious. So that comes onto another technique that I do. So first of all, it's just kind of taking them out for an hour or two and then again with some extra food. And then the next thing is, when I give them that extra food, I try and make it more processed. So processing works the food, it makes it easier for the body to digest, which, if you've got kind of normal young rats, can make them fat. If you've got older rats, it can help them keep weight on. So I'm just going to show you one of the things I term my oldie mix. So this, and I'll give you a bit of a closer view, this is a mixture of various processed grains and similar and some kind of oily fatty stuff. I think people have heard me rustling the food jar because I've suddenly got a lot more interest underneath. I should give Monster something. Oi, Monster. Yes, this is you. That's a piece of coconut. They love coconut. So that's quite a high value treat for it. And the other's my sneaker. So what do I do with this? Right, so this is a collection of all the kind of stuff. Some of it's in the normal mix, but it's more of it. All of it's processed carbs. So we've got things like dried egg noodles. So these are kind of absolutely full of kind of carbs. really easy to digest, and the rats love them, and they also quite enjoy eating them as well. So you can also use little bits of pasta, so that's like a really tiny little pasta shell. You can use bigger bits as well, it's just I find that's infinitely cute. Then you get things like your breakfast cereals, which I add to the normal mix anyway, so I've added a bit more to this. So you've got your cornflakes, your Rice Krispies, some of your mixed puffs, which you get from Resurrections. Do you want that? Yes, you do. Then good old barley rings. They're really handy because not only are they basic barley, which is a low phosphorus grain, they're also full of linseed, extra oils, which are kind of extra calories, which are very useful when they're old. And I'll explain a little bit about why linseed in particular and omega-3 oils are so important later. This is a bit of broken up dried pita bread, so I stick that in my dehydrator. You could potentially dry it on low in the oven. And this kind of goes down really well, and it's dead handy for getting supplements to stick to as well. And it's kind of, it keeps a lot better than normal bread, which was a discovery. These are just some kind of mixer from a dog food. They're low protein, which is key, so I think they're about 12-14%. But again, quite heavily processed and full of extra vitamins and such, because when the kidneys start kind of wearing out a little bit, sorry, it's a bit of a free-for-all now, everybody loves me. No, that's my finger. Piece. There, eat that. I've given you something. I don't even know what I'm saying. I really shouldn't treat the rats when I'm doing it. So the dog food mixes. The kidneys become less efficient at processing minerals and such, so sometimes they actually need slightly more, but you don't want to overdo it as well, because it puts more strain on the kidneys. So everything's like about balancing the kidneys as best you can, which is why all the grains I use in terms of like egg noodles and even kind of the wheat, it's low phosphorus forms. So I try and stick to rice and barley as much as possible. Where I can, I go for heavily processed white grains, which is the grains with the bran removed, which has all the phosphorus in it. And that's in there. I think there's also some actual just plain white rice in here, which I would show you, but it's so tiny it would look really crap on camera. I mentioned bits of coconut in there. That's there because it's very calorific, nice and oily, increases the fat. There is a few different seeds in there as well. They're smaller bits, but they'll still dig them up and find them. I think I put some vitelin in as well. Vitelin's a kind of dog soakable muesli that I often use for kittens. It's fairly heavily barley based, so very handy for this kind of stuff. You want something as well, don't you, Mum? Oh, you haven't had anything yet. No, that's cheating. Okay, free for all. Can't stop you having some, you're skinny. Yeah, have some pepper bread. Right, I'm going to put this down before the rats rob me of all the kind of oldie mix. So that kind of mix I make up. There isn't a specific set recipe. What I do is I just add a kind of fair mixture of different things. So this is, I don't feed this on its own. What I use it as is to kind of bulk up the dry mix. So what I'll do is, let's say, put two parts of the dry mix with one part of that and mix it all up. And then I will add a few supplements to that, which work really well. And I'll explain a bit about the individual supplements, actually. So I do use various ones, but these are kind of the three main ones. First of all, Senior Aid. It's a dog kind of squirty kind of stuff. It's really hard to describe what it is, kind of liquidy thing. It's full of B vitamins. So B vitamins are very important to rats that have got hind leg degeneration and kind of generally good old age vitamins. Incidentally, they're also useful when they're pregnant, but that's certain B vitamins, that is. But it's that's a separate thing. So this is really good because of the amount of B vitamins it's got in there. So I'll just add a couple of squirts. Does that taste good? It's also got like omega-3 in it, glucosamine, that kind of thing. So it is quite useful for kind of topping up those vitamins. It, as I say, it's sold for dogs. There's a cat version, but you probably want the dog version. Ellie thinks it tastes really nice out of the tube. Most rats don't like it out of the tube, so I tend to mix it with stuff. I quite often use it to help stick more powdery vitamins on. Right, we'll finish with that one. Let's go on to the next one. So the next one is omega oil. So you've got a few different options with this. So this is oils that are high in omega-3. So you want something like linseed oil, flaxseed oil, hemp oil, or a mixture, which is the kind of thing that's in here. The reason they're really important is they're very protective for the kidneys. And actually, by feeding those regularly, you can help improve the kidney health. So I give that on basically daily. You don't want to give too much or they get the runs, but a few drops on food now and again go down really, really well. Okay, you make it. And they do find it very tasty. Yes, I've had rats fight over empty bottles because they do really like it. And again, because it's liquidy, it's really useful to kind of stick powdery supplements on. So right, I'm stealing that back before you do actually eat a hole in the bottle and have a small accident. Right, so the next one that I use a lot is Epactine. So Epactine is specifically designed for dealing with kidney, like actual active kidney problems. So I wouldn't use this on kind of rats if they haven't come up with a reading on the urine of being kind of high in protein, either at home or via the vets. And I'll probably do a video on kidneys, what specifically to look for in that. I might even test Monster's urine, but we haven't got time today. Mostly because she probably will refuse to pee when I wanted to, so I'll have to catch her at some point. But yes, Epactine is like a white powder. So I should say on Senior Aid, a squirt or two, it's not rocket science. Nothing in there is going to cause any problems if you overdose on it. Oil, I've mentioned, a few drops, small squirts. It depends on how many rats you're giving it. Both of them, absolutely fine for any rat. And then Epactine, I tend to go for about half a spoon for a couple of rats. You can give a reasonable amount. It's basically calcium carbonate plus a couple of extra bits, which help kidney problems can make them feel slightly kind of sick. So, and kind of nauseous, and this has an anti-nausea thing, so it's quite handy. I put those on any kind of separate food that I give the oldies. You can give it occasionally to younger rats as well, so I wouldn't worry if I'm feeding a big group and I add a bit, let's say once a week, but I wouldn't want to give loads because younger rats do need phosphorus as well. It's an important part of their growing that they have both calcium and phosphorus. And this is a phosphate binder, so it kind of locks that phosphorus away, which is where you just have to be a little bit careful. I don't really know who's making out the chocolate. Chocolate was trying to climb something she shouldn't. So those are the three main ones I use. I do have one other actually. Though I'll be entirely honest, I do find things quite regularly. So this is mobile bones. Again, it's quite high in B vitamins and that kind of thing, but it also has vitamin C in it, which is quite useful from an immune system point of view. And again, it's kind of got some of the repetition on the senior aid. So when I'm low on senior aid, I can get hold of this and sometimes use it. It's not a bad one. You can also get... Sorry, whenever I move, I get like accosted by the rats, so it's always fun. So these are glucosamine treats. They also have various kind of nice to oldie kind of foods in them. So I kind of give them occasionally to older rats, and you are not an older rat, Tato. In fact, you have a little bit of belly, so no treats. So yes, you can give that kind of thing as well as occasional treats to kind of top them up. So this is all about kind of keeping them at a nice weight whilst they're in the main group. So I'll give that, and what I tend to do actually now, which I found works really well for me, and you have to find what works well for you, is because I work, I do struggle sometimes to kind of, and I work decently long hours to kind of take them out in that kind of 2 or 3 hours well between the middle of feedings, unless it's at the weekend when it's quite easy. So what I do instead is I have a second cage set up, and when I go to work in the morning, I will stick them in that cage, just my two oldies, with a food mixed with the oldie mix and all the supplements and such, leave them in there until I get back home from work, take them out, put them back in the group, and then they'll spend the nighttime hours, which are the more active, interesting hours for them, in the main group, and that works quite well. And that gives them a good long feed, and I might not do that every day, I'll do it as often as they need to keep the weight on. And that tends to work for quite a long time for me, so it's worthwhile thinking about. So the other thing you can do, so I tend to do this every 3 or 4 times they're in there, is another way of giving very kind of calorie dense foods is to give cooked effectively. So these are a couple of kind of dog foods that I use. I particularly like the Burns. They do an egg and brown rice one, which is my favourite because egg is the kindest source of protein for the kidneys. This is chicken, so it's not bad. They do a fish one, but it smells really badly of feet. The rats quite like it, I don't. but I do like the egg one, and you can get different flavours in there. I would say you want to go egg, soya, fish, and then chicken, and then red meat's the worst for the kidneys, just kind of a bit of a kind of rule of thumb. This is another brand I quite like, but these are both basically kind of relatively sensible, not too high in protein, wet dog foods, and they're quite good at just giving them kind of a bigger, bulkier meal, and because they're really, really tasty, the rats kind of go mad and eat loads of it, so they do look a bit pot-bellied afterwards, but it's a good way to go down, and it's also a good way of getting supplements in, where they might not necessarily always stick to dry food. That's where I like the pita bread bits, because once they've got a bit of oil on it, the powers will just stick to them, and the rats quite like that. So that's another option. So those both form kind of that irregular part of my older kind of infirm rat diets, and it goes down very well. I only have to separate my rats when it gets to the stage where there's something serious that's going to stop them. So in some cases, like the reason I had Diddy and Terry separate, for instance, was Diddy couldn't cope with the cage layout, and Terra, who was one of our friends' rat, was prone to being very, very active to the point where you physically couldn't feed her enough. Even when she was kind of temporarily out of the group, it wasn't enough for her, so she needed to be in a low-level cage. So it suited her and Diddy to move out. So that's the kind of situations I would move them out, or if I was really, really struggling in the main group, and I had some other oldies that would benefit from a bit of extra feed time. I'm quite lucky that whilst I don't have loads of rats, between me and my kind of partner rat through Lovecraft, we often have a few, and our rats tolerate, well, our rats are family, so we can kind of move them between us to find the most suitable group, which works well. Hopefully you won't need that, Chox, because I'll miss you. But yes, it does mean that they have to go to one or the other, so one of us has to miss out on our beautiful oldies. But I'd say it really does work quite well, just managing it within a group. You do have to also, and I talked about kind of cage setups for the old and infirm, so you have to respect that as well. But keep on focusing on those kind of foodstuffs. What I should also mention is if you notice the weight loss, that kind of gradual weight loss, the kind of gradual loss of mobility, that kind of thing, don't assume it's just old age. It's something that I'm quite passionate about. A lot of people just say, oh, they're old, that's it, you know, I'm just going to manage them and they're going to have to be put to sleep at some point. But every kind of symptom of old age in a rat is caused by some sort of condition. It is not just old age, though obviously they're linked with the rat being older and hence the kind of organs kind of fading a little bit and getting a little bit less efficient and so on. But Monster looks a bit older, but that is because her kidneys are kind of crap, aren't they? So we manage that. And so all I'm saying that is question it, find out what's wrong with your rats. There are various things that can cause these kind of symptoms. Heart's another one. Obviously hind leg degeneration and kidneys, which are kind of go hand in hand with older age in rats, generally speaking, even if it's kind of quite older. You can get different kind of neurological problems, you can get digestive problems, you can even get kind of background infections. So things like urinary tract infection. One day you might notice that your rat's just looking a bit rough, a little bit skinny, it's get lost a bit of weight and you don't know what, but actually it's quite often one of those. And that may well be what ended up causing damage to Monster's kidneys, something like that, because they can spread to the kidneys very easily. So it's kind of like, don't accept the rat looking a bit old. Try and get to the bottom of the why, because they may need veterinary attention and that might help them live that much longer and that much happier. But even if they don't, you can help more specifically with dietary stuff. There's some dietary stuff you can do to help things like diabetes, which happens in older age in some rats. There's things you can do that can help, like for the heart, even mammary tumours. There's dietary tweaks that you can make that will help with that. Maybe you should do one of that. Trouble is, my rats don't get that many, and it's quite nice to demonstrate with a rat about it. But I might do that on one of my later ones, because I know it's something that interests people quite a lot. So yeah, make sure you question and make sure you get to the bottom of it. But diet can make a massive difference, particularly with things like kidneys, which are very much, they're not going to get better from degeneration, but you can extend the period of time that they're happy and extend their quality of life and slow down the progression massively with diet. In fact, when the vet found out about Monster's blood test results, it was straight away, diet route is the way that he felt was best to manage it with her. And so far it's doing well, isn't it, Miss? But you still need a bit of extra food. So yes, use that, use the diet stuff. Use the kind of idea of using more calorie dense, readily available kind of processed foods to bulk up your food. Give them that little bit of extra time with food. Make sure, so if I did a starve day with my rats, which I do regularly because it is good for them, helps longevity and all that lot, I won't starve an oldie. When I say starve, it sounds like really mean. It's just a day or half a day without food. But yeah, I definitely wouldn't do that to an older rat. I will take them out and put them in a separate cage with food for that time, because they just don't have that level of kind of buffer. I would also say don't feed them to the point of obesity. It's nice for an older rat to have a little bit of extra weight because it is a buffer when they get poorly or something like that. But it also kind of puts strain on so many of the different organs, it tends to exacerbate existing conditions. So feed them so that they're a healthy weight. Don't feed them to the point that they're like a pizza rat, which I have seen, or a quiche rat because they're a bit thicker. yeah, so just be sensible with it. And they will probably enjoy it very much as well. There are also other dietary supplements you can get, things like malt paste. That's great for kind of rich calories. It also kind of promotes appetite. I know some people's rats absolutely adore that. There's a mix that I came up with, which is just kind of more of a short term or occasional kind of bulker upper, which uses a mixture of one of the rat rations, soakable mixes, which you might see. Or if you haven't got access to that, then I might do a video on making your own soakable mix up, because you can do that with just grains that soak themselves naturally. I've done it before. I'm just a bit lazy and get from rat rations now. by the way, I'm not commissioned for rat rations. I just use them because they're great. So it's two parts of that rat rations mix, two parts of complan. There's various flavours on that. My girls prefer chicken complan, because they're more savoury rats. But you can get chocolate, strawberry, so on. I'd make up a small amount and just see what they like. Vanilla, I think, as well, actually. Then there's one part desiccated coconut, so that's kind of like that dried ground stuff, great stuff for adding a bit of oil. And then coconut milk powder, which you'll find in kind of Indian bit sections on the supermarket or Indian supermarkets and so on. Quite handy to have in, actually, to kind of add extra calories to things. And that's the basic premise of it. And then I'll normally add a small handful of, like, something like that Aldi mix or some sort of kind of breakfast cereals or such, just to give it a bit of texture. A lot of older rats don't like really smooth texture. They like a bit of substance to it. And to that, you can add your supplements and so on. And that's quite good as a kind of quick calorie boost, particularly when they're very skinny. I think rat rations do make that up themselves now, which is called Moon Mix, but you can make it up yourself at home and just get the ingredients. And that's a good, like, extra bulker upper. And it's handy to have in. So, like, the problems with some of the wet dog food is you're going to be potentially only feeding one or two rats, unless you've got loads of them. And you won't get through a pack very quickly. What you can do is freeze them into ice cube blocks and chunks and perfect little rat-sized portions and get them out. So that works quite well. But something like the kind of Moon Mix, the soakable mix, is great because it keeps for a long time when it's dry, and you just add about the right amount of water to it to make up a kind of mush, and then they'll eat that. So that goes down well too. So that's what it's all about. It's kind of nutrient-dense food that's relatively balanced, but also low protein and low phosphorus. If you can tick those boxes, then you're generally going to kind of help them gain weight, and then doing it in a particular way that suits you and the rats doesn't disrupt the group too much, but kind of works. So have a think about that and see how you get on. And then I think that's probably me for the day. So I hope you have a lovely day, and I shall hopefully be seeing you soon. See you.